and who still generates excitement among ageing and indeed not so ageing rockers, who last weekend flocked to see him at the Carling Country Music Festival in Cork City.
It means rock and roll and difflement and difficulty and keep on going and craziness and good music and a V-sign to a lot of people who would have put him down a long time ago.
The paunch begins to develop, there's a creak in the old bones. You like to think back to the halcyon days of your teenhood, and for me that meant Elvis Presley, it meant Chuck Berry, it meant the great Buddy Holly, and all the greats of early rock and roll. Now when the opportunity comes at a country music festival in Cork to meet one of those greats, well that's something you're not going to pass up, especially when it's the Louisiana killer, Jerry Lee Lewis.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain, too much love drives a man insane. There's grace, there's great balls of fire. I let it love what I thought it was mine. You came along and you knew me, honey. I've changed my mind. This love is fine. The rest is just great balls of fire. Kiss the baby. Feels good. Hold me, baby. You like a love should. You're fine. So kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. That you're my nail guns and that's where all my thumb. I'm real on earth, but it's
yours. International Jerry Lee Lewis fan club. I think that T-shirt says it all.
You're very welcome. What's your name?
Ken Mahoney is the name.
Hello, Ken. What does Jerry Lee Lewis mean to you?
Oh, he means the world as far as music is concerned. I feel that there's only a few outstanding people every century born, and you know, in as far as that type of music is concerned, and I think he's one of them. To me, anyway, he's the greatest, you know.
You'd put Jerry Lee Lewis at the very top, ahead of Presley and all of that.
Well, he would to me, because I think he had more all-round ability, you know. I suppose Elvis had the voice and the good looks and all the rest, but for the all-round, you know, ability, I think he's a truly sensational, you know.
Character. Now, you came down from Dublin for this. Would Wild Horses have kept you at home?
Oh, no, sure. I went to Wembley to see him for his first appearance 2 years ago, and I think I'd go to China if I had enough money to get there.
What does Jerry Lee Lewis mean to you?
Rock and roll.
Full stop.
Full stop, rock and roll. Show business personified. Rock and roll, the late 50s. Everything to do with my youth.
To me, he is the founder member of rock and roll, the true king of rock and roll. Always was and always will be. There'll never be another.
Jerry Lewis at the Grand Old Opry House in Cork. I didn't think I'd see the day, but I'm really looking forward to it.
Open up a honey, it's your lover boy, me that's knocking.
Can I ask you, Jerry, your own rock and roll music, country music was very close to the roots of that, wasn't it, going back in the old days?
Yes, sir.
And they called you the Louisiana Killer. What is that?
I don't know, just saved and picked up in high school, you know.
Do you remember the excitement of the early rock and roll days, what it meant to you?
Well, I think it's the basics. Presley and myself and Chuck Berry, stuff like that. Rockabilly or rock and roll, whatever you call it, boogie woogie, country music, Hank Williams.
I think white America at the time didn't quite know what to do with this new sound, this new music. They,
no, they
felt threatened. How was that?
Pretty narrow-minded, some of the people were, you know. They wouldn't accept it, you know. They kind of the corruption of the youth of America.
Yeah, they talked about depraving the youth of America.
Really?
You, of course, don't believe that happened at all. I mean, the music was just an expression of how you felt.
I think so. I didn't mean it that way. I'm sure nobody else did, and I think it was something that the kids were going to accept anyway. They wanted it, I know that, and they got it.
Do you miss some of the friends from those days, the people who've passed on?
Yeah, I do. Mm-hmm. They were good people. A lot of them are gone. That's right.
But the killer is still there, and...
By the grace, really.
Why do you think that the music was so exciting to that generation?
I think that the people were just bored with somebody just standing up there with a guitar. They couldn't tune it to begin with. And, singing slow music. And they wanted some excitement. People don't want to cry all the time, you know. They like to rock a little bit, I guess. That's the way I look at it.
You must talk to me a little about the piano, especially the left hand. They all talk about Jerry Lee Lewis and the great left hand.
A lot of thunder in that left hand. But it takes two hands to really, you know. I'm pretty fast on piano, but actually I'm a violin player. Nobody would accept that, though.
You do play the violin as well, do you, Jerry?
Very little, I'm just joking. I thought I could, till my mother told me I couldn't. But it kind of hurt my feelings, but I quit playing it.
Right. One final question, Jerry. Will rock and roll ever die?
No, sir. Now, of course, everything's going to die, I imagine. But I think it will live on.
I isn't indeed old great balls of fire himself, Jerry Lee Lewis. So my favorite.